Hey guys! Welcome back to ArchiTutors. In this Grasshopper tutorial, we will learn how to design a parametric ceiling. Whether you're an architecture student, designer, or a professional, these steps will help you to create an interesting 3D geometry using Grasshopper and Rhino. Let's begin! In this Grasshopper tutorial, we're aiming to create polygons following a parametric pattern and then extrude them to create modules for a ceiling design. We can change the shape of the polygons or the whole geometry by making changes in the Grasshopper algorithm. We can implement this Grasshopper definition and the technique to create some other parametric geometry also. To start, let's open a Grasshopper. Double-click and insert Construct Point component. We're going to set a number of points in a grid using cross-reference. Insert cross-reference component. Then add series component. By default, we have a 10 by 10 grid of points. Add number slider and set values to define the distance between two points and also the count or number of points in this series. Add the component distance. Here we set two points that will work as the attractor point component in this Grasshopper definition. Enter the component curve closest point. And now we can set a curve in Rhino that will work like an attractor curve in this Grasshopper script. And set that curve in Grasshopper. Having the gumball option on, modify the curve by moving points on its segments. If you're keen in watching more of such videos and upcoming tutorials on Rhino and Grasshopper, then make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell icon for all the latest updates. Your viewership means awful a lot to us. Insert the move component and also add a z-axis component with it as we want to make a copy of the points on the grid in z-axis. These points will be the center points of the polygons for the design. We can define the number of sides for the polygon using a number slider, where three sides will form a triangle and four will create a square. Next, we insert scale component. We want these polygons to differ in size and dimension. Add the area component. Using boundary edges component, we can see the surfaces forming from all these polygons. But we want to have the surface from the intersection of both these geometries. Enter the curve closest point component and set the curve that we created earlier in Rhino. Add remap number and bounds component. Add construct domain component, and here we can add values for the scale component using number slider. We can define how much we want to scale these polygons. Here we're going to add shortest list component, that is a plugin you can download for Grasshopper, and feed in the values of polygonal geometry. Insert entwine component and flip matrix component. And adding the loft component, we extract the intermediate surface from those two polygonal geometries. These surfaces, we will extrude to create our ceiling design. Insert extrude component with Z-axis component to extrude these polygonal geometries along Z-axis. We have different triangular modules in this design that can be recreated into squares or hexagons or polygon with any number of sides as per our design. We can change the values on number sliders to get different results. This is how we can create an architectural ceiling design in Grasshopper using different polygon modules. I hope you have learned some new techniques through our Grasshopper Rhino modeling tutorial. You can check out more such tutorials from our Rhino Grasshopper tutorial playlist. Make sure you subscribe to our channel for more upcoming videos on Grasshopper and Rhino. Thanks for watching. See you next time.